School Everywhere makes it easy for students to engage during class. Whether you want to ask a quick question, check understanding, or gather feedback, you'll use an activity, School Everywhere's term for any question or interaction. Activities can include multiple choice, open-ended questions, word clouds, or even friendly competitions. In this video, we'll cover how to create, present, and manage activities in five quick chapters. Chapter 1, creating an activity. Chapter 2, customizing your activity. Chapter 3, presenting your activity in a browser. Chapter 4, presenting your activity via PowerPoint or Google Slides. And Chapter 5, tips and things to keep in mind. Chapter 1, creating an activity. After logging into Poll Everywhere, you'll land on the home screen. From here, you can create a new activity or open one you've recently used. You can also click Activities, the bar graph icon on the left side, to view and manage your activities. To create a new activity, click the plus activity button. This brings up a list of different activity types. Some of the most common are multiple choice, students choose an answer from a list, word cloud, responses are displayed by frequency, Q&A, students submit and vote on questions or comments, clickable image, students respond by clicking on specific areas of an image, survey, a set of multiple questions to gather feedback, open-ended, students type their own answers, and competition, where students answer questions the fastest in real time. For this example, we'll create a simple multiple choice activity. Enter your question in the title field and add possible answers. You can mark the correct answer by clicking the check mark next to it, or you can leave it blank if you want the activity to function like a poll. You can also organize your activity by placing it in a folder. This step is optional, but folders can help keep things sorted by course or topic. When you're done, click Create to finish. You'll now be taken to your activity's main settings screen. Chapter 2, customizing your activity. Once your activity is created, you can customize it by clicking the Configure tab. This is where you set how participants can respond and how the activity behaves. For example, you can require students to log in with their SDSU account as registered participants, or allow anonymous responses. In response settings, you can limit how many times someone can respond, or how many answer choices they can select. For open-ended questions, choose your method of moderation to allow participants to speak freely or censor offensive responses. You can also enable a timer, which lets you limit how long participants have to respond. Just toggle the switch and set the duration you want. To preview the activity from a student's point of view, click the Test tab and activate your activity. You can submit a sample response to see how it works. The Send tab's Share and Embed section gives you links to share the activity, whether for live presentation or asynchronous use. You'll also find embed codes here if you want to display results elsewhere. Finally, under Visual Settings, you can adjust colors and fonts to match your style or course theme. Once you're happy with the setup, you're ready to present. Chapter 3. Presenting your activity in a browser. You can present your Poll Everywhere activity in two main ways, through your browser or via your preferred presentation software, such as PowerPoint or Google Slides. If presenting through a browser, follow the steps in this chapter. If using presentation software, skip ahead. Start by selecting your activity from the home screen or the Activities page. You'll see two key options, Activate and Present. Clicking Present opens the activity in full screen, which keeps it active and ready for live responses. The participation link and QR code will appear automatically so students can join. Clicking Activate also allows students to join using a QR code or a response link. This works whether or not the activity is in full screen, so it's perfect if you want the activity open in the background during a lecture or for asynchronous learning. In present mode, move your mouse to the bottom of the screen to reveal your controls. You can choose instructions mode to show only the question, responses to reveal answers, or clear responses to start fresh. You can also click lock to stop further submissions once everyone has responded. If you're showing several activities in a row, use the arrow buttons to move forward or back between activities. When you're done presenting, press the Escape key or click Exit at the bottom of the screen. This takes you out of full screen and deactivates the activity. If you choose Activate, students can participate and you can control when to close or deactivate the activity by selecting Deactivate. Again, this mode is useful if you want the activity to run but not have to go into full screen mode. To view responses, simply select Response History. You can always revisit any activity to see responses by selecting it and clicking on the Response History tab.
Chapter 4, Presenting Your Activity via PowerPoint or Google Slides. To embed Poll Everywhere activities directly into the slides of your PowerPoint or Google Slides presentations, you'll need to install the designated Poll Everywhere tool. Go to polleverywhere.com, select the Resources tab, then choose Integrations. Here, you'll download the Poll Everywhere tool for PowerPoint for either Mac or Windows, or the extension needed for Google Slides on Chrome or Edge. Once downloaded, follow the instructions for installation. Poll Everywhere with PowerPoint. Poll Everywhere with PowerPoint may work slightly differently on Windows and Mac. On Windows, PowerPoint will usually have a Poll Everywhere tab right in the ribbon after you install the integration. On Mac, you'll see a similar tab, but for it to work correctly, you'll likely need the Poll Everywhere app running at the same time as PowerPoint. In this example, I'll walk through PowerPoint on a Mac with a Poll Everywhere app, but the process is very similar on Windows. Start by opening the Poll Everywhere app on your Mac.
Sign in with your SDSU email, just as you would on an internet browser. Here you'll see all your previously created activities. If needed, you can also create new activities directly within the app by selecting the plus activity button. Make sure your presentation app is open, then select an activity or several activities within Poll Everywhere. Then select Insert Slides. Some types of activities insert differently. Open-ended questions will insert immediately, while multiple choice questions will prompt you with two options: Default, which inserts a single slide, or Engagement, which inserts three slides, one to show the question, one for results, and one to lock responses. This multi-slide setup is for convenience, but if you choose the default method, these options will still be available while presenting the slide. Once the slide is inserted into your presentation, enter Presenter View, or presenter display, depending on your chosen app. As soon as the activity slide goes full screen, it activates, and students will see the participation link and QR code to join. While presenting, move your mouse to the bottom of the slide to access controls, instructions mode to show only the question, responses to reveal answers, or clear responses to start fresh. You can also click Lock to stop further submissions once everyone has responded. Moving on to a different slide or exiting full screen presentation mode deactivates the activity.
Troubleshooting the Poll Everywhere app with PowerPoint.
Make sure you're signed into the Poll Everywhere app before presenting. If you're not signed in, activities may appear blank, QR codes and links won't display, and responses won't be recorded. If your slides don't insert correctly, try quitting both Poll Everywhere and your slide app, then reopening them.
Poll Everywhere with Google Slides.
Once installed in your browser, Chrome, or Edge, a new Poll Everywhere tab will appear directly in the Google Slides interface. Select the Poll Everywhere dropdown to insert an activity. A pop-up will appear showing your existing activities to choose from, or you can select New Activity to create one from scratch. Select one or more activities, then click Insert Slides. Some types of activities insert differently. Open-ended questions will insert immediately, while multiple choice questions will prompt you with two options: Default, which inserts a single slide, or Engagement, which inserts three slides, one to show the question, one for results, and one to lock responses. This multi-slide setup is for convenience, but if you choose the default method, these options will still be available while presenting the slide. Then click Insert Slides. When you're ready to present, enter Slideshow Mode. The activity will activate automatically when its slide comes up in full screen mode. Students will see the participation link and QR code to join. Just like in PowerPoint, you can hover near the bottom of the screen to reveal instructions mode, show or hide the question, responses to view participant responses, or lock the activity to prevent further participation. Moving on to a different slide or exiting full screen slideshow mode deactivates the activity. Chapter 5, Tips and Things to Keep in Mind. You can personalize your experience in Poll Everywhere by clicking the profile icon in the bottom left corner. From there, select the Personal Info tab to adjust various aspects of your profile, including how your username appears. For instance, you may want to update the custom link to reflect your name or the name of your class. Another helpful tip is adjusting the default settings for your activities. This way, every time you create a new activity, your preferred settings will be applied automatically. For example, you could set it to always restrict participation to registered users only. Additionally, there's an option to pin a Q&A activity. This allows students to ask questions during class separate from other activities and keeps the Q&A accessible for you to review at your convenience. You can also set a default time for activities to eventually deactivate. And that's all you need to create and present activities and poll everywhere. For more help, check out our other videos or explore the resources in the description below.